Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name's Nastasia, and if you're new here, I would love it if you would subscribe. Don't forget to hit that notification bell and set the settings to all. That way you don't miss any videos in this new series. We are finally starting the home renovation process, and I'm so excited to share all of the extreme room makeovers with you guys. But for today, we are starting with the guest bathroom. Originally, I was on Pinterest finding all of this inspiration that I absolutely loved, and when I actually totaled everything out, it was gonna be super expensive. So I thought, why don't I just do the bathroom makeover myself? A little DIY project for under a few $100s. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you enjoy. And don't forget to leave me a comment down below. I try and respond to absolutely everyone. I will also have the links to everything I used in the description box down below. And without further ado, let's just jump right into it.
So this is the before of the bathroom. I wanted you guys to get a really good visual of the space that we are working with. As you guys can see, it's a pretty decent size guest bathroom, but we are going to be switching out absolutely everything in here aside from the toilet and the countertop. I thought I would save switching out the countertop for a later date, or if in the future I decide to, you know, gut the whole bathroom. There's really nothing wrong with it. It's in really great condition, and I think with everything else switched out, it could pop a little bit more. So this is the before, and I basically started off by removing all of the fixtures, starting off with the light fixture. So definitely, if you are doing this yourself, make sure that all the electricity is shut off. This can be really dangerous if it's not. So turned off the electricity and went ahead and removed that light fixture. It was a little bit of a pain, so I did have to get a little bit of help to just hold it. My biggest concern with this mirror was that it was going to be glued to the wall and I would have to break it to get it down, but it actually wasn't. I was able to just remove the brackets and separate it from the wall. It was a little stuck just because it had been on this wall for so long, but it actually came off in one piece and I'm excited to repurpose it and use it for something else. My biggest tip with this project is definitely clean up along the way. That way, when you're done, you have like a nice clean bathroom. I went ahead and removed all of the hardware from the drawers as well as the door handles, just because we are going to be not only painting this cabinet, but we're also going to replace all the hardware. I just thought it would look fresh with a nice set of gold hardware. So that's what we're going to replace this with. But now that I got all of that hardware off, I have a few more things to remove, like this little toilet paper holder. And as you guys will see, I did have to patch up the wall a little bit here. Not a big deal. You can totally sand over this and then just paint a little paint on to the wall and fix it, no problem. But what we're working on here is the color that was behind the mirror when I removed it. You guys will see this was actually the original color of the bathroom at one point. So I'm just going in here and adding one layer of paint. I'm going to add one coat, and I'm definitely gonna have to let it dry and add a few more just to get rid of the color, since it is such a yellow toned color that was on there before. You are gonna have to cover it with a few coats of paint. Before we can start painting our bathroom cabinets, of course, we have to go ahead and sand them down. I love this sander that my grandpa let me borrow. It has a ton of different attachments on it, so I was able to get into all the little grooves and stuff. So I would highly recommend investing in something like this if you don't have it already, because this definitely came in handy and I can see myself using it again. But I just went over everything really nicely and made sure everything was nice and smooth. And then as far as the drawers went, I just sanded them down by hand. I found that that was actually easier. So after I got everything nice and sanded down, I was ready to paint. I'm using some Benjamin Moore paint. You guys saw I put this paint actually in my old apartment, and I had some left over, and I thought this would just be the perfect pop of color for the bathroom. You guys know I usually stick to neutrals, but I love a good pop of color every now and then. So I'm using this really nice olive green, and I think it's going to tie everything together so nicely. Before you paint your bathroom cabinets, you definitely want to go ahead and add some painter's tape. That way you don't get it on the wall color in your bathroom. Of course, I use painter's tape and I still managed to get a little bit on the wall, but since this is a matte paint, I actually was able to wipe it off quite easily. So I just did painter's tape on each side, as well as there's a strip of painter's tape that you can't see that is underneath the cabinet where it borders the actual countertop. So make sure you actually add a piece of it there. But I'm just going in with a paintbrush. You can use a foam roller for this, but because these are the sealed drawers, I just found it to be so much easier to have a paintbrush. So I went in and added just one coat. And I really like this paint because it's very easy to layer and it ends up drying really flat and matte, which is so nice. A pro tip from me, before you start any plumbing work, make sure that the water is turned off in your home. You do not want to have water splashing all over the place. Now, the faucet was a little bit tricky because I'm going to show you guys here. That faucet that was in here before had been in there a really long time. So it was really hard to get it out, but once we did, it was super simple to just go ahead and add the little rubber washers here and then go ahead and put in the new faucet that I chose. And I went with a matte black, which is something very different. I've never had any like matte black faucet or fixtures, and this looks amazing. As I mentioned to you guys, I really wanted to save the countertops, and to me, this draws in a focal point to the faucet instead of the countertops. So you don't really realize that they're just the original older ones, and I think it looks awesome. The cabinets are still drying, so in the meantime, I went ahead and added in that second coat of white paint to the back wall where the mirror used to be. This is super important because I am installing a smaller mirror. And of course, you can find me singing or dancing to pass the time, so I felt like I should just leave this in here because this is what I'm doing half the makeover. And I just did the little finishing touches around the sink. And then it was time to add the second coat of the matte green paint to the cabinets. And all I needed were two coats on that back wall, as well as two coats on the cabinets. That's all you need. And it dried super nice with no streaks or anything. So now I'm also cleaning up the floor because you need to make sure that the floor is nice and clean. I even recommend like a light mopping and then letting it dry before we go ahead and install the peel and stick flooring. I decided to add the hardware on before I put the floor in, just in case I needed to do any paint touch-ups after this step. You don't get any paint on your brand new floor. So I just went ahead and added back on this new hardware that I got. Just a nice pop of gold. I just wanted something different instead of all the silver. So I added these on and I learned very quickly that whoever changed the hardware before had messed up some of the holes. So this was a little bit difficult to get some of these on. I actually ran to the hardware store to get different screws. It was a little bit of a mess, but we figured everything out. While I was installing these doorknobs, my grandpa was actually helping me fix the drawers. Those we actually found out that at some point someone had took a drill to the holes, which is not what you do to make them larger. And so he was able to fix those just by using a washer. So after I just did a few touch-ups to the drawer and I pushed it in just to let it dry, so the doorknobs and drawer pulls are on perfectly now, it was time to put in the floor. Now make sure when you're doing this that you start in the most visible place first. If you can avoid making cuts to the details on these peel and stick tiles in areas where your eyes are drawn to, that is the goal. So I started in this corner because I measured everything out and I noticed that the cuts would easily be made underneath the cabinets. So you're not even gonna see that I had to cut some of the tiles in half and that there are cut lines or little pieces missing in the pattern. So that's definitely my pro tip with this peel and stick tile, but it goes on so easily. This is amazing. And to me, this transformed the whole bathroom. I'm just being resourceful and using the box that it came with to step on and to step down on the tiles just to make sure that they are nice and secure. When it comes to the areas like around the toilet, what I found was the easiest thing to do was to actually push the tile down as much as you can and then take a little box cutter and cut around what is still up, if that makes sense. As you can see, the area that's still up, I just cut around it, and that's how I knew exactly where the line was for the toilet. I found that that was the easiest way to get this done. Also, you should definitely leave a little space around the toilet in case it needs to be regrouted at any point in time. That way, if this does need to be regrouted, I don't have to pull up all this tile. There's that little area around it already there. So definitely keep that in mind as well. I just continued all this peel and stick tile throughout the whole bathroom. I used about 3 boxes of this. I can definitely see myself using these tiles in other areas in my home just because it was so affordable to just switch out the floor really quickly, and I finished this in like 10-15 minutes. Fun fact, this actually isn't the light fixture that I originally chose. The one I chose was shattered when I opened the box. I totally forgot to show you guys that, but it was a mess. I ended up going to my local hardware store and picking this up, and I'm actually happy that happened because this is a LED light and it totally transformed the lighting in this bathroom. This bathroom never really had that great of lighting, and this just changed that completely. So it was a blessing in disguise. I brought it back and just kind of winged it on the measurements. So as you guys see here, I'm just praying that it fits, and it does. So went ahead and turned off all the electricity, obviously, to get that installed, and it looks great. It gives off just the best lighting in here. I'm so happy with it, would highly recommend. Also went ahead and installed the new mirror. It was way too heavy for one person to install it. However, it is really great quality, so I definitely would recommend it. Just make sure you hang it up properly. Moving on, I went ahead and installed the new toilet paper holder, which is super cool. I found this online and I thought it was awesome. It actually has that little shelf, which is intended for you to set your phone on, which is great, so you don't drop your phone in the toilet. So I just went ahead and screwed that in to the wall. It was giving me a little bit of a hard time under there, but I got it nice and secure. Then I just put the toilet paper roll back on there. I really like the little shelving detail on there. It's so cute. And then I have another industrial inspired piece that I put in here. This is a towel rack holder. I think it's super pretty. You could obviously DIY this, but I just went ahead and purchased it myself. I'm finishing off the towel rack with some of these tasseled towels. These are one of my favorites from Target. I just think they're super cute, and I love the little embroidery detailing on them. The next decor piece I'm adding required 2 screw hooks that I just put into the ceiling. So actually I put the first one in and made sure that the planter was hanging in the right space that I wanted it. And then judging by there is when I added the second screw hook, just to make sure they were the right distance apart. But I went ahead and added these fun little geometric hanging planters and just added 1 real plant and 1 faux plant. I like to mix them together now. I'm also adding in one of my display favorites. You guys always ask about this, and I have not been able to find that picture anywhere. I added in another amber glass piece and another decor item that I got from Target. I really like the fact that it said hello there. I thought it was super cute. In the corner here, I'm adding in this side table as well as a basket for toilet paper, just so my guests can see that there's extra toilet paper right there ready to go. And then I'm finishing the top off with some of my favorite home decor magazines. So that is that for that cute little corner. On the actual countertop, I found this fun little brass tray as well as some other decor from Target that I'm adding. I went ahead and added a candle pedestal with my spa day candle and this wood beaded garland, which gave me a ton of problems before I felt like it was in the right place. I tried moving it around so much, but as you guys will see here, I finally realized that I should just wrap it around the vase a few times and that looks better. So then I added the candle pedestal back in after that. So those were my little finishing touches to the bathroom. I wanted to remind you guys what the before of the bathroom looked like, because I am so happy with the after. It looks amazing. I cannot believe I was able to do such a transformation on this space for the price that I was able to do it at. So I would highly recommend and encourage all of you guys to get in your bathroom and DIY it yourself. Trust me, you can do it. This is actually totally a one-day project and you're done. This did take me a few days just because I am renovating, as I mentioned, the entire house. So I'm skipping around a little bit. However, if I would have started in the morning, I could have finished this at night if this was the only project that I was working on. So I would definitely encourage you guys to try this yourself. And if you do, make sure you tag me in your photos on Instagram. At Nastasia is my Instagram. It's always linked down below. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Leave me a comment in the comments down below. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!